I'm honored and privileged to once again address you on the occasion of the holiday season as the parliamentary representative for Denry North. As the year 2020 draws to a close, living in its wake, unprecedented levels of uncertainty and despair the world over, I am confident of our ability to rebound. The perils of 2020 manifested themselves in the form of job losses, the passing of loved ones, and restrictions on everyday activities. Despite the setbacks, we have to be thankful for life and for having endured and survived a year that was difficult for many. Let us allow the holiday season to renew our sense of community and love for each other. It is a time of year when we are expected to do more to help those among us who cannot always provide for themselves. I know 2020 was a difficult year for many of you in Denry North. Our children, like their peers throughout the country, lost hundreds of school hours because of COVID-19, time which must be recovered in the coming year. Several of you who were employed in the tourism sector either lost your jobs or suffered massive pay cuts. It was another dreadful year for the banana industry, an industry that has done wonders for the development of our community for more than 50 years. The many rejected shipments of our harvest on the regional market have undoubtedly hurt many families in our community, as well as other banana producing areas in St. Lucia. The situation has been made worse by the closure of Winfresh and the failure of the authorities to establish a suitable replacement that would provide relief for our hardworking banana farmers. As 2020 draws to a close, so does another term of government. The past 4.5 years have been extremely challenging for me as an opposition parliamentarian, trying to discharge my duties to my constituency. My continued omission from decision-making for key community initiatives has been disconcerting at times, but not for once has my resolve been broken. I will continue to project my voice in the parliament, mainstream media, and other fora in giving expression to the plight and concerns of the people of Denry North, whom I have the distinct pleasure and honor of representing. Amidst the uncertainty and confusion of 2020, one of our biggest achievements was the completion of the $40 million Denry North Water Redevelopment Project, initiated by the St. Lucia Labour Party, funded by the Government of Mexico, and a loan from the Caribbean Development Bank. Today, all the communities of the valley enjoy a safe and reliable supply of drinking water from the ultra-modern Tamazo treatment facility. I did all in my power as a community leader and parliamentarian to ensure that we consumed clean, treated water. I feel a personal sense of victory at the completion of this project. The Larissa's Health Center, which was destroyed by fire a few years ago, remains untouched, despite my many pleas to the government. The Austin Hill Road and the Elemon Road in Grand Rivière, for which contracts were signed prior to the 2016 general election, are still in a less than desirable condition, as are the Cady Belmont Road, the Rich Waring Road, the Twafre Road, and the Tonnes Farm Access Road, among others. Despite being starved of state resources and certain duties of the parliamentary rep being hijacked by a ruling party hopeful, in the new year, I will continue to engage the various government agencies and departments in much the same way that I have for the past 9 years, with a view to addressing the problems of my constituency. I will not allow myself to be sidelined. I will continue to be the voice of the people who elected me. Effective representation cannot be diminished by being starved of state resources. I know the last 12 months have been very difficult for many of you, but you owe it to yourself and your family to take a break from the stresses of life and for one moment enjoy the company of loved ones during this holiday season. Let us treasure our loved ones, embrace our friends, and accept others for who they are, irrespective of their circumstances in life. 2021 is poised to be a challenging year, one that will thoroughly test our mettle and resolve. However, I am confident that the determination, resilience, and lion-hearted characteristics that have always differentiated us as a people will see us through. On behalf of my family, my staff, my constituency group, other well-wishers, and on my own personal behalf, I would like to extend season's greetings to all St. Lucians at home and abroad. In particular, the wonderful people of Dernier-Rivière, Belmotte, Olean, Despin, Gadet, Grand Rivière, La Ressource, La Pelle, Richfond, and Grand River. And may God shower his richest blessings upon you and your family throughout 2021 and beyond. L'année 2020, c'est une qui tenait en chaque difficulté pour mon monde la terre. Et pas seulement en cette ici. Mais moi, l'école perd un chaque temps pour la petite COVID. Situation figla, c'est une qui pas bon pour fama pour les moments. Mais nous voulons remercier bon Dieu pour la vie et pour la santé. Et pour prendre l'occasion de célébration Noël 2020. Pour souhaiter tout le monde constituant et tout le monde cette ici. Un joyeux Noël. Et puis la bonne année 2021.